On Tuesday, March 27th, I chaired a hearing of the Senate Investigations and Government Operations Committee, where I was joined by colleagues from both sides of the aisle to ask tough questions of the presidents and CEO of NYSEG, Con Ed, and Central Hudson Energy Companies. This was not about politics, and it wasn't about finger-pointing. It was about good government and moving the problem to a solution. This was about working together in a bipartisan way to make sure the Hudson Valley even becomes a better place to live. Just in case you missed the live stream of the hearing, here are a few highlights which took place right here in Albany.
I think everybody knows why we're here with regards to the two nor'easters that we had had within the 6-day period. With regards to the devastation that happened specifically in Westchester County and Dutchess County.
Storms Riley and Quinn inflicted a total of more than 3,000 wires down, more than 400 broken poles, and damage to both transmission, distribution, and infrastructure. In the Brewster Division alone, serving Westchester, Dutchess, and Putnam counties, more than 160,000 customer interruptions occurred between the two storms, affecting 83% of the population in that region.
Riley impacted 105,000 or more than a third of our customers, and it was our fourth most severe storm in the last 50 years and exceeded the outages that we had from Superstorm Sandy in October of 2012.
Our meteorologists tracked Riley as it approached our territory, and we advised customers to brace for a winter storm and possible outages as we prepared for the mobilization of our crews and schedules.
So part of our investigation will be to see what caused those failures, and part of it will be what went right.
I do not want to be doing this and saying, we're calling for another investigation. We're calling for, this is nonsense.
Right.
This is actually nonsense. Coming from the second floor down to all of us, it's nonsense. Enough's enough. This has been going on for 6 years, and we need to get this right. Between you guys working together with our utility companies and us, if it's legislation that we need to pass, right, so be it. Hurricane Lee, Irene, Sandy, the ice storms, the wind storms. I mean, there was investigations into that, correct?
Correct.
Despite the investigations, why do we have these failures time and time again? Because, I mean, this goes back, you know, to Hurricane Sandy and Irene and Tropical Storm Lee, and that's May of 2013. This is Hurricane Sandy. This is September of 2012. This is 6 years later, and we're still going over this stuff, where a lot of this stuff, I believe, should have been fixed. Governor Cuomo announces, issue on that was in 2013, Tropical Storm Lee and Irene. So, as recently as 2 weeks ago, he called to he's clean up your act.
Right.
You know what I mean? This is your boss saying, listen, we got to clean up our act. What are we doing?
There were investigations of prior events. There were a lot of recommendations. There were actually significant statutory changes to the public service law, which we are thankful for, strengthening the storm response protocols, strengthening requirements of the utilities to include certain provisions within their emergency response plans. Our powers were strengthened in terms of our penalty powers. Penalties were increased.
Fining utility companies is not the answer, in my idea. Working with them is probably a better idea. We had 77 people on life support that we had to go out and take care of. 158 people were critical care. Found one kid, like I said earlier, this kid, a 39-year-old who's a quadriplegic, who his parents were too proud to call. And I will give a shout out to Kathy Calhoun, who stepped up to the plate to make sure we got a generator to this kid's house at 1 o'clock in the morning.
Right.
Those are things we shouldn't be scrambling around to do. We should be better than that. Mm-hmm. These reports, these investigations go back and back and back. So the ones I just pulled off your website, 2012. Mm-hmm. 2012, that's 6 years.
Right.
And we know these storms are coming more and more every year. It's not once in 100 years. These are massive storms. So We have to change.
We have some of the highest utility rates in the United States of America. It's an extra $1 billion. Harden it up for us. It's our money that we're paying.
Yeah.
Bring it back home. How many actual numbers of guys that you had in-house and then the mutual aid or the contractors, the third-party contractors that you had to pull in from outside?
The contractors came as they could get there as quickly as they could. They came from Canada. They came from all over. We felt they stepped up and really tried to help New York.
And I want to give them a huge thank you. A huge thank you, because these guys were working 17-7s. They were out there in a storm. It was very dangerous. I absolutely totally get it. So you're saying 800. We're getting these 100-year storms every year. So this has to be, your vegetation management program is got to be on spot.
There are opportunities to identify trees that are risks, not only to our system, but to the community. In advance, it is very challenging to affect a tree removal that's outside of our tree trimming practice, frankly.
And
that's something that I think there is an opportunity for us to all work together more on that going forward.
The pines snap at the top, and a lot of the damage, they snapped and came right down on the wires, and just the telephone poles just went tumbled down one at a time. So I know the governor had sent a bunch of utilities down to Puerto Rico. I asked this question because a lot of constituents were bombarding me with it. What are they all down south? They all down south, so.
Senator, we had 10 linemen in Puerto Rico from both RG&E and NYSEG, utility companies, total of 10. And we had 3 support personnel. And then we had the same complement of vehicles, 5 line type vehicles and 3 support vehicles.
We had 50 who were in Puerto Rico at the start of the storm. Of our employees, overhead line workers, and approximately 70 contractors who would normally work for us. So, and when you're early in a storm and every individual counts, it had an effect.
When you know a storm's going to hit a particular area, and you can count it, if you have 10 trucks,
yeah,
you gotta pay the overtime, you gotta do what you gotta do, but embed one of those trucks in with each municipality. Well, you two know your towns better than anybody,
well,
and the police department.
We actually had our OEM director in North Salem ride with their crew chief that they had, I forget where he was from, ride through the town and show him the entire network, show him where all the problems were. And they got the whole, as I said, he gave them the priorities where the problems were. They got the whole thing back up in 5 hours. I had people telling me this was still down. I was texting back and forth. It worked superbly well. And you know, they have phenomenal line people. They had a crew, the second storm that was coming when it just started getting bad, I think it was about 1 p.m, the snow was terrible. And I was out on the road over on Nash Road with the crew that they had. And I said, they had to put a pole in, put the transforms up, and it's terrible snow. And I said, you guys gonna stay here? And he said, we worked last Friday. They're from Buffalo. He said, last Friday we worked in 2 feet of snow. This is a flurry. I was like, you're the perfect people for this job. But
on retrospect, we also had companies in from Texas that they said they haven't seen anything like this.
Right.
We're trying to get down to the bottom of that. So these 100-year storms, I don't want to be back here next year, nor do you.
What you just saw is why I am so, so honored to be your senator. It feels great to work with everyone to get the job done. Thank you.